friends. I'm just an average American. But I'm an American-American. And some of the things I see in this country of ours make my blood boil. I see people with foreign acrimony. I see Negroes holding jobs that belong to me and you. Now I ask you, if we allow this thing to go on, what's going to become of us real Americans?
I've heard this kind of talk before, but I never expected to hear it in America.
This fellow seems to know what he's talking about.
What are we real Americans going to do about it? You'll find it right here in this little pamphlet. The truth about Negroes and foreigners. The truth about the Catholic Church.
Do you believe in that kind of talk?
Well, makes pretty good sense to me.
And I tell you, friends, we'll never be able to call this country our own until it's a country without. Without what?
Yeah, without what?
Without Negroes. Without alien foreigners. Without Catholics. Without Freemasons.
You know, Masons? What's wrong with the Masons? I'm a Mason. Hey, that fella's talking about me.
And that makes a difference, doesn't it?
These are your enemies. These are the people who are trying to take over our country. Now you know them. You know what they stand for. And it's up to you and me to fight them. Fight them and destroy them before they destroy us. Thank you.
Before he said Masons, you were ready to agree with him.
Well, yes, but he was talking about... What about those other people?
But in this country, we have no other people. We are American people.
What about you? You aren't American, are you?
I was born in Hungary, but now I am an American citizen. And I have seen what this kind of talk can do. I saw it in Berlin.
What were you doing there?
I was a professor at the university. I heard the same words we have heard today. But I was a fool then. I thought Nazis were crazy people, stupid fanatics. But unfortunately, it was not so. You see, they knew that they were not strong enough to conquer a unified country. So they split Germany into small groups. They used prejudice as a practical weapon to cripple the nation. Of course, that was not easy to do. They had to work hard to do it. You see, we human beings are not born with prejudices. Always they are made for us. Made by someone who wants something. Remember that when you hear this kind of talk. Somebody is going to get something out of it. And it isn't going to be you. This is not classroom theory. I saw it happen. You must never let ourselves be divided by race or color or religion. Because in this country we all belong to minority groups. I was born in Hungary. You are a Mason. These are minorities. And then you belong to other minority groups, too. You are a farmer. You have blues. You go to the Methodist Church. Your right to belong to these minorities is a precious thing. You have a right to be what you are and say what you think, because here we have personal freedom. We have liberty. And these are not just fancy words. This is a practical and priceless way of living. But we must work at it. We must guard everyone's liberty, or we can lose our own. If we allow any minority to lose its freedom by persecution or by prejudice, we are threatening our own freedom. And this is not simply an idea. This is good, hard common sense.